told you that within the next decade, you could be spray painting on your clothes every morning instead of, you know, getting dressed the boring old-fashioned way? Would you think I was crazy? Well, get ready, because by the end of this episode, you might get yourself a glimpse into the future of your closet, and it's gonna have itself a lot of spray cans. Hello, Internet! Welcome to Style Theory, the channel that takes a can of silly string and calls it fashion. I have a question for you. Have you seen the viral video of the spray-on dress? It's a hard one for us to show on YouTube. Not exactly monetization-friendly, but we're gonna do our best. At the Coperni runway show during Paris Fashion Week, model Bella Hadid came out sans garments. Not exactly the weirdest thing that happens during a runway show, but what came next was one of the weirdest things to happen during a runway show. Suddenly, she's swarmed by people using what looked to be heavy-duty airbrushes, and they start spray painting on a dress, but not using body paint. Instead, what they create is a fully formed, tangible dress out of what looks to be silly string mixed with paint. Then another designer comes out adjusting the shape. The whole demonstration took less than 20 minutes. It even earned Bella the Model of the Year award at the 2022 British Fashion Awards, which, yeah, apparently is a real thing. Most of the response was, "Whoa, that's so cool, I wanna wear that." But you know me, I wasn't gonna be satisfied until I knew how they did it and whether this could be the fashion revolution that we've been waiting for. So today, I'm here to answer the question, is spray-on clothing part of our fashion destiny, or was this just a one-time runway stunt designed to get the views over on Instagram? Well, Coperni was the one to bring the spray-on dress to the runway, they didn't do it alone. Collaboration between multiple companies in the fashion world is pretty normal, especially at keystone moments like New York or Paris Fashion Week. Many designers collaborate with other companies to produce the show-stopping numbers that we see walk in the runway. And in this case, the collaborator was a company called Fabrican. The dad puns be strong with this one, and Matpat approves. This cheeky quote-unquote fabric maker was founded by a Spanish fashion designer named Manel Torres, aka the Chemist Taylor, which, can I just say, such a cool nickname. It's kind of like Heisenberg, but wearing something much better than tidy whiteys and chinos. He came up with the idea of being able to spray on your clothes while attending the Royal College of Art in London, after he saw someone using a can of silly string, or as he likes to call it, ribbon spray. And it made him rethink the entire idea of how fabric could actually work. You see, the fabric we wear every day, from your shirt to your socks, is usually made by weaving strands of different materials together and interlacing them in a grid pattern to create a solid sheet of fabric. Making cloth like this is a whole fascinating process that I won't be getting into today, but through the magic of physics, the interlocking design of regular fabric allows it to be sturdy enough to hold its shape while remaining flexible enough to wear and move in. How then do you produce woven fabric in a can? You don't. You reinvent the process using science. I suspect that we're at the top of a deep, deep fabric in a can iceberg, and in order to reach the bottom, I need to dive deeper and uncover all of Fabrican's dark, dirty secrets. And boy, did I find the motherlode. Theorists, allow me to introduce you to the patent for Fabrican. For those of you who've never known the joys of reading patents, consider yourself lucky. They are boring, a snooze fest, but they do contain a lot of information that we need to figure out how this spray-on dress actually works. Since patents are made to help people own the rights to their specific designs and to keep people from copying their homework, so to speak, it needs to contain all the minute details about the thing being patented, from how it works, how it can be used, and how it differs from anything else out there on the market, which is perfect for us. So, let's get to reading. Yep, still boring. Okay, here we go. According to the patent, calling what comes out of the fabric can a fabric is being pretty loose with the definition. As I touched on earlier, fabric, as we normally refer to it, is made up of long woven strings of material. However, that's not what Fabrican does. Fabrican uses short fiber strands, and I mean really short, between 0.02 and 0.15 millimeters in length, and then glues these little strings together using polymers. Polymers are just a general term in chemistry and material science that covers an enormous amount of stuff that we use to make everything from plastic bags to heart valves. But at their core, they're basically long chains of repeating sections of molecules connected into one long string similar to the beads of a necklace. These polymers are acting as a binder for the fabric strands, and according to the document, they can be made from things like latex or polyvinyl acetate, which you probably know better by their common name, good ol' Elmer's glue. Who would have suspected that the future of fashion is actually just a 2014 slime tutorial? The last ingredient chilling in the can is arguably the most important, because it's the one that lets the whole process work. That is the solvent. The solvent's job is to keep the binder and fibers from mixing together too early. In the case of Fabrican, that solvent could be made from ethyl acetate or acetone, aka the same stuff that's used in your everyday nail polish removers. Which means that while the dress may make you look like the belle of the ball, you're probably smelling more like Harley Quinn after her acid bath. Anyway, this mix of fibers, binder, and solvent is what gets sprayed out and stuck to your skin with those giant airbrush-looking devices that we saw him use on Paris Fashion Week. The solvent evaporates as the spray leaves the nozzle, letting the fibers and binder finally meet and mix to form the fabric, like a really scientific and fancy paper mache. As for what kind of fibers you can make your outfit and a can items from, seems like you're not limited to just one type. As listed on page 7, lines 5 through 20 of the patent, you can use anything from cotton and wool, which are pretty typical fabrics that you'd find in your closet, to aramid fibers, most often used to make bullet-resistant body armor. And if you keep going all the way to the bottom of the list, you can even make it out of glass and metallic fibers. You heard that right, glass and metal fibers. Can you imagine stepping up to get your hashtag OOTD sprayed on and instead you're just getting pelted with thousands of tiny little glass shards? Talk about death by a thousand cuts. Now, for those of you who might be thinking that I'm being a little harsh here, since Fabrican lists that it can be used for things other than clothing, like coverings for furniture, nope! Still not seeing a world where I want to plant my butt on an office chair coated in metal and glass shards while I sit through yet another 9-hour title thumbnail meeting. That is my literal nightmare. All joking aside though, they're not wrong about the versatility of Fabrican. It is nearly limitless. While Torres designed Fabrican to be a tool for his fashion dreams, anything you can imagine that uses some sort of fabric-like substance could simply be sprayed on. Aside from clothes and seat covers, Fabrican claims that it can be used to make consumer products like sponges and towels, automotive interiors, art, even potentially used to clean up oil spills. Yeah, right? Not too shabby. To do that, all you have to do is just follow their diagrams, which are giving off some serious IKEA vibes, until you've even extended the use of Fabrican to include the medical field. According to Fabrican, you can create medical patches, bandages, casts, and masks that are just sprayed directly onto the patient, making them custom fitted.
One of the main characteristics of being able to have a liquid fabric contained in an aerosol is that makes this material totally sterilized.
And it doesn't even stop there.
Another big element, you can add nanotechnology, even drugs, medicines, to be able to have an instant patch, as example, a nicotine patch.
So mix stuff with the fabrics and binder and boom, you can have a new way of delivering medications to patients with just the spray of a can. On paper, this stuff is basically a one-stop shop for all your fabric needs, but the flexibility of the fabric usage here isn't the only selling feature. Fabrican also aims to turn the tide on sustainability. Even looking at the demonstration of this stuff on the runway, it's immediately clear how it would be so much better to have the ability to make clothing in the exact size and shape of the wearer instead of mass producing huge numbers of pieces, only to hope that they manage to fit the majority of consumers out there trying to buy it. There also seems to be relatively little waste of cloth in this demonstration, which played directly into the sustainability buzzword that's been looming over the fashion industry over recent years. In a world where people are throwing out an estimated 92 million tons of textile waste every year, a fabric that wastes less material, that could be a game changer. Shout out to Sam Reich. On top of also not using as much material to create a garment in the first place, another massive selling feature of Fabrican is that it can actually be reused. Yeah, as in melted down and resprayed again. Fabrican states on their official website that the goal is to, quote, provide industry with production processes that reduce environmental impact, since it primarily uses fibers recycled from discarded clothes and other fabrics. Each Fabrican item can be worn and washed just like a normal garment. Yeah, I was surprised by that one. And once you've tired of your runway dress or your custom pair of spray-on Junko jeans, you can then break it back down into its base parts of fibers and binders, add the solvent back in, and spray the same material time after time after time, creating completely new items. Kind of like a reusable 3D printing method.
It can be removed, washed, and reworn, or, if you prefer, just dissolve it and start over.
I mean, this sounds like the most revolutionary material in history, right? So why is it just in a specialty runway presentation and not in your closet right now? It sounds too good to be true. Well, yeah, kinda. Looking at all the benefits seems great, but it turns out that there are plenty of things that Fabrican't do. But hey, before I go pouring one out for Fabrican, I think you should take a minute to hit that subscribe button to join the community of 1.3 million style theorists. We are well on our journey to hit that 2 million subscriber milestone. So smash that subscribe button so you don't miss when we dive into the science behind what color goes best with your skin tone or whether Peach's parachute dress could actually hold up in real life. You do not want to miss anything that's coming up, my friends. And now, back to the episode. The first thing I noticed while watching the initial video from Paris Fashion Week was that the dress was quite form-fitting. And while Miss Hadid looked comfortable, not everyone is as body-con positive. Some some of us prefer a little bit more room in our personal style, a little more flow. So I wanted to know what other styles Fabrican could actually do, and it turns out it's a lot of the same thing. Dresses, much like what we saw on the runway, or skin-tight shirts, not quite the versatility that we were promised. Then again, I can probably forgive this one because Fabrican suggests they can make different sizes and shapes using robot arms and molds to apply the fabric. But now let's look at the application. It took two artists around 10 minutes to apply just one dress, and another person to come in and make the alterations. While the final product truly stunning, it was still just a dress with no zippers or buttons, no real layers, no cutouts or embellishments other than a head hole, and no laces, fringes, or anything else with actual style. Just a covering for the old bod. As we see here from the 2010 Science and Style show, you can make some pretty wild shapes using Fabrican, but they require essentially sculpting out each shape individually, and the pieces don't exactly come out feeling organic or natural. As an everyday person who's not the craftiest, see also my craft challenges on GT Live, I'm not gonna be able to make something like this. So the only way that Fabrican works for me is if there's also a designer slash architect slash paper mache champion also in the can. Otherwise, I'm just gonna wind up as a first grade art project. And all of this is without mentioning one of the biggest considerations here, the actual durability of the fabric, which seems questionable at best currently. In this image from the same fashion show, you can see that Bella Hadid's dress has already started to tear in the corner after she's done something extreme. You know, she walked. And this doesn't bode too well for any uses of Fabrican other than experimental fashion. Could you imagine spray on sportswear, kids' clothes, even basic clothing for dancing? Anything that requires any movement could immediately damage the fabric, and the only way to repair it is to melt the whole thing down again. Speaking of wearability, that actually is probably the biggest elephant in the room with Fabrican. The fact that it's not just made from fabric, it's also made from polymers. Now, polymers are amazing, great, super flexible building blocks of chemistry. They're also completely non-breathable. Remember when I said the polymers used in Fabrican are similar to Elmer's glue? Well, have you ever worn Elmer's glue? It's not what you'd call the fabric of our lives. There's a reason glue is great at sticking things together, mostly because it's non-porous and forms a tight seal. But wearing a material like that is gonna feel a lot more like a wetsuit than a slinky evening dress. I'm sure Bella Hadid was happy to have something nice and insulating to wear out there on the runway after standing around in her skivvies for 20 minutes, but in the real world, anything made out of polymer materials is likely gonna be something you're sweating in, and then getting stuck to as you're left to marinate in your own clothing. Sure, it might look good on the outside, but a couple minutes in this stuff is probably gonna be pretty awful. And finally, I should probably mention the cost, which Fabrican seems to keep hidden away at the bottom of the can. The only price tag that I could find was in an article from 2010 saying it could cost $15 a can when it released next year. Next year in this case meaning 2011. But there is no indication of how many cans are needed to make a single garment. Is this a one can fits all situation? I don't think so. There were two at least half gallon jugs of Fabrican sitting on the cart next to the model in the runway show, and they sprayed for almost 20 minutes straight, leaving me to believe that this was a pretty serious commitment in terms of materials. Given that there are no benchmarks out there in the space, guessing that price is not a selling feature that they want you thinking about just yet. So I'm gonna assume it's not an accessible price point for consumers outside of Paris Fashion Week. Does all of this mean that Fabrican is a lost cause? No, not at all. I'm not here to crush Fabrican's dreams of changing the world. I'm just here to put the viral marketing through a real-world lens and remind everyone on the internet that if it looks like something impossible is happening in a video that you saw online, then something impossible is probably happening in that video that you saw online. Even though Fabrican has been kicking around for over two decades, it's still very new when compared to the tens of thousands of years that we've been using things like cotton and wool to make fabric. And the patent itself even admits that rigorous testing has to go in to find the correct binder and solvent for every type of fiber. They also have to do more experimentation to nail down the right ratio of the different ingredients that'll produce a usable form of clothing. Like all attempts to overhaul a centuries-old industry, it's gonna take time. And hey, if Fabrican would like to send me to the streamies this year in a suit made of wool and glue, I am here for it. Just give me a few months heads up so I can try to work towards something closer to Bella Hadid's figure. I'm looking more like Bella Hadad at the moment. But hey, that's just a theory. A style theory. Keep looking sharp. And hey, if the science of fabric tickles your fancy, click the box on the left to find out what the Hulk's pants would really have to be made of. Or click the box on the right to find out if you can actually be allergic to color. As always, my friends, I will see you next week.